Hi students, how are you all? Yeah, we are in the fifth session, the ending of the lesson. Hope you are all doing fine. In the last session, we have seen the prefixes, adding some prefixes like an, miss, im, dis, in, ir. By adding these kinds of prefixes before the word, prefixes are added before the word. By making them opposites, we have wrote some words, right? In this class, we are going to see the grammar in the lesson, right? In page number 59 from your textbook, it says, read the following sentence here. Tess smiled. Tess smiled. Tess answered. The chemist said, she knew that Andrew was sick. She knew that Andrew was sick. All the above sentences speak about the actions completed in the past. Tess smiled. Smile means she smiled. That action has completed before, right? Tess answered. Answering action has also been completed in the past. That action is not going on now. So that is the action of the past, right? And she knew that Andrew was sick. She knew means she know is present tense. She knew is past tense. So, above all the sentence speak about actions completed in the past. They are said to be in past tense. Yes. The verb used in such sense is generally made by adding ed or d or by making some changes to their present tense form. Said, knew are the past forms of say and know. Certain verbs like cut, put are the same in the past from form also. Cut, put, they do not change their present and past tense. In present tense they are cut, in past tense they are cut, right? Verbs such as sit, hold, cut are called irregular verbs as they form their past tense differently, right? Here is one box. I'll read present tense and past tense. Reach. What is the past tense for the word reach? Reached, right? Next is add. What is the past tense for the word add? Added. Touch. What is the past tense for the word touch? Touched. Next is play. Present tense. Past tense, played. Next, visit. Past tense, visited. Avoid is present tense. Avoided is past tense. Complete is present tense. Completed, it is past tense. Die is present tense. Died is past tense. Live is present tense. Lived is past tense. Keep is present tense and kept is past tense. Sit is present tense and sat is past tense. Teach means teach. Is a word which refers in the present going time. Thought is a word which is used to express the actions which are completed in the past. Right? In the next page, it says, read the following text and fill in the blanks with the correct forms of the verbs given. Right? Read the following text and fill in the blanks with the correct forms of the verbs given. Right? Last Sunday, I dashed to Abby's birthday party. What is the past tense of the word go or the verb? Correct form of the verbs given. What? Last Sunday I went to Abhi's birthday party. Went is the answer. All my friends dash on that occasion. Gather. What is the past tense form? Gathered. gathered. Right? Next. Rahman dash music. What is the past tense for play? Played. Rahman played music. There it is given play. John dash Hindi songs. What is the past tense for sing? Sings. Sings. Right? Hindi songs. Shoban dash to John's songs. What is the past tense word for dance? Danced. Rahman danced. Sorry. Shoban danced to John's songs. Abhi's sister dash sweets. Distribute. What is the past tense for the word distribute or the verb form? Distributed. Distributed. Right? Abhi dash a cake. Abhi dash a cake. Abhi cut a cake. Cut does not change. In present tense and past tense, it is the same. Abhi cut a cake. Abhi grandparents dash him. What is the past tense for the word bless? Blessed. Blessed. Right? Abhi's grandparents blessed him. Abhi's father dashed him a new bicycle. What is the present tense form of the word present? Presented. Presented. Presented, right? Bicycle. Abhi dash very happy. B. Abhi. B. Abhi was very happy. B past tense was. B present tense was past tense, right? 11. We all dash have a good time. What is the past tense for the word have? Had. Had is the past tense word for the word have, right? Now read the following pair of sentence, right? She used to play in page number 60 from your textbook. In page number 60 from your textbook. She used to play with her brother. Ismail used to play kabaddi in his childhood. Now he plays tennis. Sarma used to watch English movies when he was 18. Now he watches Hindi movies only. Yasmin used to run 5 kilometers every morning when he was young. Now she walks 2 kilometers every morning. Here, used to is used to speak about the things that were habitually done in the past, right? Here, used to is used to indicate the actions which are completed in the past. Now, write 5 sentences about things that you used to do when you were in primary school. You have to write this by your own, right? Next. Writing. Next is writing. Next is writing. Diary writing. You have read a story that of a little child saved the life of her brother. Yes, in the $1 and 11 cents, what can a dollar and 11 cents do? We have read the story of little child saved the life of her brother. Andrew recovered completely and returned home. Tess was very happy. Let's see what she wrote in her diary that night. See, dear diary, Friday, September 11, 2020, 9 p.m. She is writing in her diary. Today I am very happy to see my brother back at home. Now he can play with me. He can go back to his school. He can eat well. My parents are also very happy. I am very thankful to the surgeon, Dr. Armstrong, for saving the life of my brother. He is a very great person. I should also become a doctor like him. I should also serve the poor. I should support my parents. We will have happy days thereafter. This is the diary writing that she wrote after her brother became well during night 9 p.m. Right here. Now imagine yourself as Tess brother Andrew and write a diary entry for the day. Right now, what you have to do is you have to imagine that you are a Tess brother Andrew and you have to write a diary entry for the day. Right. Now, this is how you will write. Thank God, Friday, September 11, 2028 p.m. Dear diary. You can also see this one in your study material, page 144. And you have to write this diary writing in your notebooks, looking from your study materials. In page number 144, it says, thank God I am still alive. When I heard my parents' words, I thought that I must meet my death. It's really a miracle. Because of the great doctor, Mr. Carlton Armstrong's efforts, I am alive today. I am really indebted to him for all he has done for me. I am indebted to my loving sister too. She showed great love, affection and courage in bringing the doctor and showed me to him. Now she is very happy. My parents too are very happy. They thought that I wouldn't live for a long time with my malicious disease. Their joy knew no bounds when they came to know that I would be saved and would lead a healthy life. From tomorrow onwards, I can play with my sister. I can play with my friends. I can go to school. I once again thank the doctor who has saved my life. He is God to me. This is the way you have to write the diary writing. It is there in your study materials. You have to write in this diary writing in your notebooks. Next. Picture based story writing. There is a picture. Looking at the picture, you have to write a story. Right? Look at the picture and develop a story by using words given in the box. Give a suitable title to the story. The beginning and the ending of the story have been given. Write in your notebook. What is the title that you can give to this story? We can see a man sitting in chair, a farmer. What is the hints that is given here? A farmer, four sons, fell ill, quarreled, sticks broke, bundle of sticks, unable to break, decided not to quarrel. A farmer, four sons, fell ill. We can name this story as the old man and his four sons. The old man and his four sons. The story goes like this. This story is also there in your study materials. You have to write this story in your notebooks. Understood? Once there lived a farmer, he had four sons. One day he fell ill, they began to quarrel among themselves. The farmer was very sad by looking at this, his sons fighting together. He wanted to bring a change in them. He thought for a while. He got an idea. He called all of his four sons. He showed them a bundle of sticks and asked them to each to break the bundle as a whole. Each one of them came forward and tried to break the bundle but could not. Then he asked each of them to untie the bundle and break a stick each. They did it easily. The farmer told if they were united, they would be strong. If they continued to quarrel as earlier, they would become weak. The son decided not to quarrel. They lived happily. The moral of the story is unity is strength. If we live in unity as brother and sister, we can be strong, right? Without fighting. Next, Next, you have read the following sentences. Read the following sentences. Right? In page number 62 from your textbooks. Show me the way to the railway station. Please show me the way to the railway station. Could you please show me the way to the railway station? These are three types of sentences. All these sentences are used for the same purpose. The second and third are polite requests. When we request somebody for something, it is always better to be polite. Yes or no? When we need something or when we ask something, we need to ask them politely. Yes or no? We should not ask them harshly. If you ask them harshly, they will not help you whatever you need. Right? Next, read the following sentence which indicate politeness. Please tell me the arrival of the time of Charminar Express. Here, please means we are requesting. This sentence is in polite form or in request form. Next, please tell me the platform number of Godavari Express. Could you please tell me about the wheelchair availability? Could you please tell me whether the Prashanthi Express is running on time or delayed? Could you please tell me the way to the cloakroom? See, all these sentences indicate a kind of politeness or a kind of a request, right? So that when we are requesting or when we are asking the other people, when we show politeness and request towards them, they will try to help us instead of asking them harshly. If we use polite words and the request words, they will easily help us, right? Next, in page number 63 from your textbooks, use the expressions in polite forms. Your classmate or teacher will help you, right? Right. First one, bring me some stamps from the post office. Bring me some stamps from the post office. How we can change this sentence into polite one? Please. Bring me some stamps from the post office. Please, you have to add before bring. You have to add please before bring. Next, help me in getting down the train. Help me in getting down the train. How can we convert this sentence into polite sentence? Could you please help me in getting down the train? Could you please help me in getting down the train? You should add could you please before help, right? Next, see, hold this bag for a while. How can we convert this sentence into polite sentence? Please hold this bag for a while. You should add please before hold. Please hold this bag for a while. Next, D. Wait for me at the tower clock. How can you modify this into polite sentence? Could you please wait for me? You should add could you please before wait. E. Lend me 100 rupees. We should add please before lend, right? Please lend me 100 rupees. Next, fifth one, F. Tell me the bus number to Trunk Road. What comes here to make it polite form? could you please tell me sixth one, could you please comes before tell, could you please come before tell, right? Next, wash my luggage till I come back. What comes here? Could you please wash my luggage before till I come back? Could you please? Next, feed my pets for 2 days. Please comes before feed, right? Please comes before feed. Is next, ninth, right? Close all the windows. Could you please close all the windows? Please. Last one. Reduce your TV volume. Please reduce your TV volume. You have to write all this one in your notebook, looking from your study material. Right? Understood, all of you? And last, you have the project work. It says, though Tuff was a young girl and had a little money, she was able to save her brother. Now, what is your project work? Is collect a few success stories like that of Tess from magazine and newspapers. Talk about one of them in the class. You have to collect a success story of any person and you have to write the story in A4 sheet and make them as a project. And this is the end of our lesson, and you have to submit the project in the school.